Greetings, dear friends. I present your attention the most common malfunctions and breakdowns that occur on the first generation Audi A8. Four-wheel drive transmissions are usually much more of a hassle than modern drive transmissions, but not in this case. In terms of the strength of the mechanics, Quattro even surpasses the front-wheel drive versions. The load is distributed more evenly, despite the more powerful motors. No wonder that motors of the cars are all-wheel drive. The problem is perhaps in the age and the large number of nodes. Something will inevitably fail over time, and sometimes replacing inexpensive components no longer helps. You have to change the entire nodes. On cars with front-wheel drive, the outer foam CV joints are inconsumable. With aggressive driving, they may not be enough for 100,000 kilometers. On all-wheel drive, the mileage before replacement depends on the service life of the CV joint cover, which is prone to damage, but other things being equal more. Mechanical gearboxes, like gearboxes, are reliable, but with gauge leaks get stronger and stronger, and without all, no components can work for a long time. With 4.2 engines and a V8 diesel engine, special attention should be paid to the silent blocks for mounting the rear gearbox. At this age, they need to be checked at every MOT. If you ignore the damage to one or two silent blocks, damage will quickly go beyond the chain, propeller, shaft, shank, cross pieces, intermediate support, CV joints of the rear axle. There is no particular hassle with manual transmission, except that the wear of the second gear synchronizers often leads to the need for a double squeeze when shifting up and the obligatory rebounding when shifting down. And again, let me remind you about the oil leaks. On the S80, manual transmissions work at their ultimate strength and folding quite often, but they are extremely rare. Nevertheless, the racers on cars of this class preferred automatic transmissions. In principle, the car was lucky with the automatic machines. On cars from V6, up to 1998, there was a Volkswagen's own development of the O1 keybox, the most powerful versions of the well-known Volkswagen O1N from the mass models. The automatic transmission of this series is very conservative and reliable. The main threats are slow overheating, which is very harmful to her because she has a lot of the plastic parts inside. The bell body is very sensitive to dirt and its wiring is very fragile. With runs over 150 to 100,000 km, the blocking linings of the gas turbine engine wear out and begin to contaminate the valve body channels very quickly. The box loses oil and plastic parts. With timely repairs, it will take the same amount of time, and the repair itself is relatively simple and inexpensive, like spare parts. But in most cases, the automatic transmission is still conceived to death by attempts to tailor it for repairs and even age, you know. Much more often than O1K, there is an unambiguous box hit of the late 20th century, the 5-speed ZF5 HP19, known for many cars as the turn of the century. Since 1997, it can be found with all the engines on the A8, from the humble 2.5 turbo diesel on the 3.7-liter V8. For motors 4.2 and 6.0, a more robust version of the 5-stage ZF5 HP24A is in store, which is capable of digesting up to 440 nm of torque. In operation, both automatic transmissions are extremely similar. Extremely successful and balanced boxes of this service have a resource that strongly depends on the mode of operation. With careful pedaling, the structure can successfully cover up to 250-350,000 km without any particular difficulties. With active movement, the wear rate of the blocking lining of the gas turbine engine sharply increases, the degree of contamination of the valve body and the wear of the solenoids. Moreover, the 5HP19 gas turbine engine tolerates severe operating conditions much worse than not 5HP24A, and earlier requires a bulkhead, but the mechanical part of the younger box is still a little more reliable. The main bearing parts here are the oil pump, its bushing and separator plate, but the friction discs and planetary gears hold on to the last. The 5HP24A has more mechanical problems. In active riders, the clutch drum A is damaged, the retaining ring is torn out of it, and along the way, its clutches with diesel discs burn out. One of the overcoming clutches and bearings also suffers. There are reinforced parts of the market, so this is the case when a quality refurbished or industrially remanufactured box is really better than a new one. With quiet operation, the resource of the 5HP24A box is not less than that of its younger brother, but at the same time, breakdowns for the most part lead to a sharp failure of the unit. And with constant movement in a sporty style, if this expression is generally applicable to the large sedan, the resource may turn out to be insultingly small, literally up to hundreds of thousands of kilometers. So do not be surprised if A8D2 you are considering has a capital or changed box several times already. Problems with electronics and well-body wiring, Cylinders and pistons in automatic transmissions of the 5HP19 and 5HP24A series are common to one degree or another. All of these components were improved upon release and changed during the repair process. But remember about age, high chances of poor quality repairs in the early 2000s and harsh operating conditions. It is also bad that Audi has officially announced the irreplaceability of the old in the boxes, as a result of which the extremely expensive original literally a few owners decide to change preventively. Official dealers not only did not undertake such work, but even intermediate by withdrawing from the guarantee those who wanted to do this operation. And yes, of course, there is no need to pour oil at the price of 4,000 rubles per liter, exactly the same but not branded cost less than 800. Just change it more often. Age-old automatic transmissions run much longer in the oil changes at least partially every 15-20,000 km, and for greater safety, additional radiators for cooling the boxes have been installed. The engines used in the Audi A8 D2 didn't yet carry the bad genes of the more recent FSI engines. On the contrary, these were extremely successful designs, moderately conservative, with good characteristics and reliability. The resource of most of the units is such that now some are still only asking for overhaul. But motors and their power supply and control systems cause a lot of minor troubles. Common problems are undoubtedly poor engine bay wearing, especially on the V8, very poor fuel tanks and the fuel lines. The cooling system turned out to be rather flimsy. The pumps, pipes and radiators are leaking. At the same time, servicing such motors is very difficult due to the tight layout of the engine compartment. Again, this is especially important for large V8s. All engines are distinguished by a complex power system and the richness of auxiliary equipment. The motors with 5 valve cylinder heads brought down below also have an extremely complex structure of the cylinder head itself. The multitude of design options and the limited compatibility of most designs significantly increase the complexity and cost of maintenance. Almost always, replacement is possible only for a completely similar unit. All alternatives will be comparatively or partially incompatible in terms of the control system and the power system. Up to the another piston group, pellets or oil pumps. The fuel tank will require a separate paragraph. The weak electrical part of the fuel pump and the easily breaking fuel gauge are far from all the problems that every A8 owner will face. The complex U-shaped design of the tank has one electric pump in two parts, which is located in a special accumulator into which fuel is poured from a filter neck, and the return is fed into it. Fuel supply from both parts of the tank is carried out by two injection, acting due to the pressure difference in the liquid flow, pumps in the pump flask. As you can imagine, such a system works only if all its components are completely clean and tight. An assembly-disassembly is fraught with a bunch of difficulties and good chances for a bulb and a drive to break, damage to the pipes and the pump float. Therefore, it is not surprising that many craftsmen familiar with this gloomy prospect simply refuses to climb into this jungle and prescribe a replacement tank assembly. The simplest and rarest engines are V6 2.8 AH series 163-173 horsepower 12-valve engine of the very old series. It is difficult to meet them alive, but in fact there are a few weak points. If the motor was locked after and a good overhaul was done, then it will be unpretentious and cheap to maintain. Ignition system with simple coils and wires, reliable timing, very simple and old blockheads. The resource is from 500,000 km or more, but usually it has already been worked out for a long time because the motors were installed before 1997. More recent V6 of the same volume with a capacity of 193-210 liters, the ALG, ACK, RPI and series already have the aforementioned cylinder head with 5 valves per cylinder, a complex timing belt with a belt and a chain connecting two camshafts, and a phase shifter on the intake shaft is more powerful version. These motors are noticeably more economical and more powerful than the old W8H, but they are significantly more expensive to maintain, and the resource, all other things being equal, is lower, although they walk 300-350,000 km easily. The cylinder block is the same here, but the design is much more loaded. The operating temperature is higher, the pump resource is lower, the cylinder head repair is noticeably more expensive. Cracks between the valves often appear, and the piston coke much faster, especially with overheating or a bad oil. Leaks are also more common, and the crankcase ventilation system fails very often. Let's add here expensive individual ignition coils, a very quick failure of lambda sensors and catalyst. Most of these engines are produced in the Euro 3 version, so there are two catalysts here and lambda as many as 4 pieces. Plus, in comparison with the old 2.8, it is also obvious. Cars with such an engine can be noticeably newer. It was installed from 1995 until the very end of the model's production. gradually improving, and the situation with spare parts and contract motors is much better. You can find even more recent copies. As a result, this version of the unit is more preferable than the somewhat more reliable but old AAH, which is difficult to find for replacement in good condition and for the desired control system. V8 engines are also of two generations. Before styling, it has 3.7-liter series AEW AKJ and 4.2-liter series ABZ AEM AJH with 4-valve cylinder head. The design is not so conservative. Individual coils, electronic coke. The timing belt is driven by a belt, but the camshaft are again connected by a chain. Of the successful features, the power of the engines is 3.7, less than the tax, 250 horsepower. In general, this is just a good, the old motor with a good study of the design. All the same problems with the pump, coils, wiring and sensors as on the multi-valve V6, but the cylinder head is almost no prone to cracking and the piston group is quite conservative. It has a good resource and low tendency to coke. Difficulties are observed with thermostats, a flow meter and the depressurization of the fuel supply line, and the interface between the flexible and rigid parts is often manifested. As a result, gasoline flows directly to the exhaust manifold with known risks, so be careful and keep a fire extinguisher ready. The newer motors 3.7 series AQG, AKC and 4.2 AQH, AVP, AUW, AKC, BCS, AYS are distinguished by 5-valve cylinder heads, the presence of phase shifters and a higher degree of boost. And in the number of options, the oil appetite is more pronounced. Otherwise, the differences are minimal, and at the same time, there is no interchangeability. As mentioned before, there are many different options that differ in intake, type of sensors, and calibrations. You will have to sweat with the research of details. W12 is rare, and it is simply stupid to argue about the practicality of such an option. If you find it for an acceptable amount, and the tax doesn't bother you, buy it. You will get a cheap young timer. In fact, these are two VR6 familiar Touareg. From the pros, a simple power system, and from the minuses, a cylinder head that is overcomplicated even by the standards of the A822, D2 and a huge mess. Diesel engines 2.5 TDI are very practical, not to be confused with the infamous newer inline 5. But given the age, there are still plenty of problems. In particular, be prepared for increased camshaft wear and imminent cylinder head repairs. The likelihood of depressurizations of the intake and airing of the fuel line is above average. The P44 injection pump often burns off the electronics, and the mass airflow sensors of the system has a relatively small resource, especially if the inlet sucked dirt from the street. Glow plugs are prone to sticking, their ignition system is not particularly reliable, but the control unit also fails and the wiring burns out. If the EGR valve is dirty, the entire intake is clogged with soot. Turbines here are Garrett GT20V, GT2052V, in several versions, very simple and cheap, with a resource of about 150,000 km. True, they also really do not like dirt and the inlet, and also overheating and low oil pressure. The price of an original turbine is about 40-60,000 rubles, and a good cartridge for it will cost 712. And to top it all off, like all engines in this generation, the 2.5 TDI is very prone to oil leaks from under all the gaskets. On this, information about the problems of the first generation Audi A8 is exhausted. If you know more or disagree with what you heard, I'm waiting for you in the comments.